everyone, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Doxy Mom, and this evening I'm here with Miss Peanut, and we wanted to bring you some more news and JFK Jr., some information that I found out on him as well. So, but first, if you have not subscribed, I would greatly appreciate if you just hit that little red subscribe button, and you can share my content. You can ring the bell to get notifications. And if you like this video, just give it a thumbs up at the end. But first, I want to start out with an article I found from the Epoch Times, and I will link the video to this in the pinned comments below. And guys, if you'll give me just a few minutes, it takes me several hours to upload these videos, and then when they do upload, I'll go in and make a pinned comment about all of the videos and things that I will be linking to this. But and according to the Epoch Times, children in social services system, foster care mainly, are most at risk of being trafficked. What happens is they put the children in foster care, and then these pimps target these children. You know, they come up and they're nice to them, give them all this attention, and then convince them to run away from the foster care family and run right into the arms of a bunch of monsters. So 88% of all sex trafficked children come from this social services system. So this is so sad, guys. And we have to pray that they can get this stopped. And we have to pray for those poor abused children. And you know, we need to make the family stronger. That's what he went on to say. That he said that if social services comes in and a parent fails a drug test just one time, then they can take the children away. If you're homeschooling your children and you don't keep up with the records and your paperwork, they can take your child away for educational neglect. And we just need to bring marriage and family back into the family. I taught home economics for 18 years, and we had this wonderful class called Life. It started out as independent living, then they changed it to life management, then they changed it to life, then they changed it to personal finance, and took all of the marriage and family and parenting parts out of the curriculum. And guys, we need to get this back into the curriculum. I just think that it's vital for our young people to know how to deal in a crisis situation, or, you know, what are good tips for staying married and having a happy and successful marriage. So let's just pray about that, guys, that, you know, we can get some good things back into the educational system. Now, moving on, Whoopi Goldberg, this is a statement that she made. She said, now I want you to think about this, taking away abortion rights is anti-human. Anti-human? Guys, it's anti-human to take away the life that's in the womb. You know, I mean, this is a real life. And if you go back a couple of videos, I even played my soon-to-be granddaughter's heartbeat. Guys, she is going to be born in less than a month, and she is a person right now inside the womb just as much as she'll be a person next month when she is outside of the womb. So, you know, guys, if you're a pregnant person out there and you just feel like you cannot care for this child or you don't want this child, then please have the child. Give it up for adoption. There are many wonderful couples out here who would love to adopt. And Wendy's is raising money for adoption. So we all need to be out there supporting Wendy's. And I wanted to read to you Matthew chapter 18, just two short verses, 6-7. It says, "But whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a millstone were hung around his neck and he were drowned in the depth of the sea. Woe to the world because of offenses, for offenses must come, but woe to that man by whom the offense comes." So, there you go, guys. We cannot hurt our children. Now, I don't know if you have seen Kellyanne Hubbard's new videos. She's put out about 5 videos over on Drop Space. I will leave a link. Just give me a few minutes to get that hooked up. But she's got some awesome, awesome videos on JFK Jr. and his plane. Now, his plane number was N529JK. Of course, JK after his father. 529, May 29th, was John F. Kennedy's birthday. So, isn't that very interesting? And our favorite Anon's post, number 529, and it says, "Hello, George." And we all know about Junior's magazine that he named George, and he did this because he felt that George H.W. Bush was mainly the main one responsible, and then there were others in the New World Order with him that was responsible for his father's death. And then, apparently, JFK Jr.'s plane has been flying around, and it has made 3 stops at Quantico. Now, Quantico has rules, guys. It says civil aircraft are not permitted to land at Quantico unless they're on official business. And on July 14th, July 19th, and the 20th, his plane in 2018 landed at Quantico. On March 2nd, 2019, his plane landed at Quantico. Now, the owner of the plane is Skydogs LLC out of Fairfax, Virginia. And this Skydog is actually Thomas Knapp. And according to Kellyanne, Knapp was in the middle of the Kennedys at the Moon Township Rally. And he's the front guy of the front company keeping the plane for JFK. Now, the plane has been seen circling around a sign that says Highway 17. Well, we all know what that means. 17, 17th letter of the alphabet. And one pattern made a sword. Now, I don't know if you know this or not, but JFK Jr. had a tattoo of a sword on his arm, and we're going to talk about that, and I'm going to leave a link so you can go and look at the picture of it. But I found an article in the Maine Republic email report, and I looked, and I could only find that a David E. Robinson publisher, so I'm assuming that this is his work, so I want to give him the credit. But he pointed out that that tattoo is a dagger pushing through a Z. Now, guys, Project Z was first, and we think that Project Z started with JFK. And Kim Clement, he had a prophecy. He said he was seeing A to Z, A to Z. And then he said, no, Q, A to Q. So, this, you know, it all ties together. But going back to the tattoo, the dagger handle is a cowboy boot with a spur. And according to Mr. Robinson, and I feel this way myself, he thinks that Junior took an oath and a pledge and an oath to God, himself, and his father to take vengeance against the New World Order crime syndicate for murdering his father. Robinson translated the tattoo as, "I will ride you like a cowboy with my spurs until I plunge my dagger through your evil heart." So, I just thought that was very interesting. Also, the gravesite for JFK was set in a plot that measured 5 by 5. And if you follow our favorite Anon, you know what 5 by 5 means, right? You get it? That is an influential statement in that movement and in the war against evil that is used by President Trump and Anons everywhere. And then we all know, or we all think, that Junior has played Vincent Fusca. And do you know what that means? Vincent means conquer, and Fusca means darkness. conquer the darkness. So I recommend that you go back and watch my JFK Jr. Could He Be Alive video. That's kind of a theory of how he, the whole plane deal and how he wasn't on the plane and kind of how everything very well could have happened. And also, just one last little fact, Jr. was Catholic. And I even looked this up, guys. The Catholics, they prefer when you die to be buried. And if you are cremated, that your remains are kept in a sacred place, never to be scattered or divvied up in any way. That's the Catholic stance on that. Well, we all know they spread his ashes in the sea. Or that's what they think. That's what they want us to think that they did. Because there's just been so many lies. But like I said, I'll link these videos. Kellyanne, she is a Christian woman. God has given her this gift to line up all these numbers. It's really fascinating. So I just wanted to bring this video and give you another update. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Please share it. My content is free. And until next time, this is Doxy Mom, and God bless you all.